you think society's perspective has changed on conditions like vitiligo?
I definitely think it has. My son, who's 26, has developed vitiligo a few years ago.
Right.
And he's mixed race, so he has quite dark skin and he has white patches around his eyes, his mouth, his fingers have now gone completely white, and he's got sort of patches sort of appearing over his body. Mm. He completely, like Joti, has accepted it straight away. He's never covered up. I don't think he ever will. I think it's because, you know, with social media and people like Winnie Harlow, and you know, there's so much more awareness now about the condition that he, you know, to him it just doesn't mean anything at all to have vitiligo, and he, you know, he's the complete opposite.
But
to
perhaps
me.
You have helped him, Polly, in that.
Yeah, maybe.
You know, maybe
I think he's probably seen the way it sort of affected me since he was born, and how it sort of shaped my life, that he's gone, actually, that's going to be the opposite. You know, I'm not going to become a slave to my patches. I'm not going to worry about what people think of them or how I look. Yes. And I think, and it's great, and I'm so glad. You know, obviously, I feel quite guilty that he's inherited this condition from me, but I'm happy that he's been able to embrace it straight away and has a completely different attitude to it.
Yeah. And of course, what it does, which is so important, and going forward as a culture and with societal expectations, that acceptance of diversity is absolutely essential.
If you are someone who is struggling with your body image and confidence, you can reach out to Polly, Liz, or myself.